So hello guys, it's Daniel, nice to see you again. In this video I'll show you what kind of protection gear is available for skating, as well as how to wear your gear to be safe while skating. First there's the protection gear. This allows us to be more safe in case of a fall or accident. On the other side there's the light and reflective gear, which makes it possible to be seen at night or in dark cloudy weather. So, let's take a look at the protection gear. First, I'll show you the basic gear, which every skater should wear to be more safe while skating. And hey, protectors are a good thing for everyone. For beginners, for advanced skaters, as well as for pros. First, there's the skate helmet. Most important to prevent serious injuries and accidents or falls. I myself witnessed how a helmet protected a boy from a deadly accident. So please guys, I know it's uncomfortable, but it's extremely important. And please pay attention that your helmet doesn't shake around. For a properly fit helmet or another part of protection gear, it's best to try it on at your local store. But if you don't have the convenience of a local store, measure the range of your head or other needed body parts. Then use the size table of your dealer and order the right size. And that's value for every part of protection gear. So let's take a look at the second and most useful part of protection gear, the knee pads. They are needed to be able to fall precisely and safely in almost every situation. But remember, knee pads and other pads aren't all equal. There are significant differences. I recommend the use of knee pads with a cover for your knees and a big plastic cap. For example, those kind of protectors are made from Powerslide, Injury or TSG. But instead of those, I also recommend protectors like the protectors I almost always use. These protectors are from the brand G-Form. They are extremely light and very flexible. For me it feels like wearing leggings and no, I'm sorry, I don't wear leggings, but I'm sure it feels the same. However, G-Form protectors are very soft, but in case of a crash or an impact, they will become extremely hard. And that's the reason why they are very comfortable and safe as well. Well, for both kinds of protection gear, it's very important that they fit perfectly. In case of a fall, crash or impact, they shouldn't be able to move or slip off of the body part to be protected. Lastly, there is one important difference between the kind of G-Form protectors and others. These protectors here have a shock absorber between your body and the protective caps. So they are much better to be safe in case of a high vertical drop, like skating on a half pipe, vert ramp or other high vertical obstacles. I think you should use them while skating high vert ramps. And in my opinion and experience, G-Form protectors are also good to be safe while skating a vert ramp, but in case of a vertical drop onto the flat, it will hurt anyway. Believe me, you will miss the shock absorbers. However, G-Forms are also perfect to be protected and safe while skating, for example fitness skating, urban skating or aggressive skating, doing airs, grinds, lip tricks and others. Good, so let's take a look at the third most important pads. These are the hand protectors, or better, complete wrist guards. In most cases, hand protectors like the protectors I'm wearing are enough. They will protect you from abrasions or lacerations. But remember, if you want to be protected against bone fractures like a wrist fracture, you should use complete wrist guards. So the last standard protectors are the elbow pads. They can be very useful in case of a fall with high speed, as well as in other situations. At this point I will let you know what kind of protectors I use. For my knees, shins and elbows I use the protectors from G-Form. For my hands I only use hand protectors instead of complete wrist guards, because I like to be able to still grab and do handstands. And that's it, these were all usual protectors. But if you like to be safer, you may also use other protectors like shin guards, protective pants or crash pants. For example, if you slip off of a lip trick or grind or just miss your grind, shin guards can be very helpful. They will save you from intense pain. And that's the reason why I always use shin protectors. And crash pads, for example, you may use when you're trying or practicing new tricks like a 540 in a mini ramp or pipe. But I'm sure you will also find other possible uses. And well done, that's all for protection gear. Let's take a look at the light or reflective gear you can use for skating. Did you already skate at night? Skating at night is very fun, especially with reflective gear and amazing lighting. but skating at night can also be dangerous. For example, therefore you may use light bands, specialized shoelaces or shiny wheels. And in my opinion, it not only looks good, the police will also be grateful. I myself use light tubes as well as photon wheels from Powerslide. And especially the photon wheels. Look amazing. And well done, that's all. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and thanks for watching. If you want, don't forget to support my videos and channel. Thumbs up, subscribe, comment, share or do all of them. Thanks again and have fun. See you guys next time.